This is the box.
Yeah, I present to you my escuadrón.
Abracadabra! Abracadabra!
My beautiful spirits, how are you doing today? I hope that you're doing positive and amazing and con mucha fuerza espiritual. God bless you. Muchas bendiciones para ustedes. Thank you so much for coming back to my channel. I want to tell you that I miss you, all of you. And thank you so very much for all your comments, your positive and amazing comments that make my day and you make me smile. Thank you so very much. I'm going to send you positivas energías. Positivo, positivo. Con mucha fuerza, my friends. Mucha fuerza mental. I want to tell you about part what I was doing these couple of weeks that I was a little of stress, but you know that all these years that Jeff is in prison, the only way that I have to know what's going on, I've been calling on the phone, calling, talk to people. You know, some people are nice, some people they don't want to hear, but I am consistent even talking and calling people, so I want to know what's happening, how this system works, because I don't know nothing about it. So it's the first time I'm experienced to have a son incarcerated. You know, and I was showing you in the past videos about Jeff, he's been doing programs, and also Jeff did the GED program, like you know, and thanks God he passed. And because he did that program, the correctional department of Florida give an award of 60 days, you know, of gain time. A couple of weeks ago, I received a phone call. The person that was on the phone is the director of the GED program, the director of the education department in the facility. He calls me and he said, hi, Mr. Haynes, I have a young guy that I want to speak with you. So, you know, he calls me just because, you know why? Because few months ago, I guess a year ago, I've been calling him because I want that Jeff getting that program, and was kind of difficult that Jeff getting the program. And then when Jeff was in the GED program, so Jeff has, you know, was kind of a lot of frustration because they didn't give him the test, and he knew it about, he was preparing because they transferred Jeff for many times, so he always stopped the program. Start the program, the GED program, and then they move him, and then they don't, you know, re-enroll him again. So, conclusion, Mr. Chills is the name. Mr. Chills and me, he knows me because I've been talking to him all this time. I create a connection with him. I start a connection with him during that time, so he knew who I was. So when I received the phone call, was Mr. Chills. So he said, Mr. Haynes, I have a young guy here in the office with me, and he wanted to speak with you. So I knew that it was Jeff. So Jeff, they was in the speakerphone. So Jeff says to me, you know, mom, I already passed the test. So he gave me that news on the phone, you know, in that office. That these people, they don't do that. They don't put inmates in office. They to do that phone call, they don't do that. No way, they don't do that. So Jeff told me, mom, I passed the test. He was so happy. I was screaming. I was crying. And then Mr. Chills talking to me again. And he said, Mrs. Haynes, I don't do this for nobody. But because me and you, we start a connection. That's why I'm calling you. So he says that to me. And then also he says to me, here in the facility, nobody, no parents, nobody called me about the inmates, about the program, what how they do, and they never called me. So for me, it's something weird that you call. So that's why I'm making this phone call for you to talk to your son. When you make a phone call to the facility and start asking questions about how is your loved ones, you know, your related, your family, so they can know that the inmate has family that cares for that person. It's very important that you do that always. So when they gonna reduce the 60 days of the sentence? So he says to me, you have to wait because it's a process. We have to wait maybe 2-3 weeks, a month, because it's a process, Mrs. Haynes. Tallahassee is have to be the one who reduced the time, this and that. So, okay. Okay, so I said, well, that's a process. So, and then pass 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, and you know, it's something about like I have to call, I pray, so I make a lot of phone calls, to be honest. Even though Jeff says, don't call, please don't call, because people talk, I don't want that you call. In my mind, I said, oh my goodness, the only way is like I have to call, because I wanna know. This is not like I have to wait for too long, because I don't trust the system, and I don't know if they're gonna give in the 60 days. I don't know. Who knows? Maybe they don't give it to them. I don't know. Is that right that they have to give it to them? But you don't know. I don't know anymore. I remember I left a lot of voice message, and I remember it was on the Thanksgiving's week, so everybody was out of the facility. The guy, the supervisor, the classification supervisor, was the one who has to give me the information, because when I make a phone call, somebody reply me, somebody call me back, and this person said, you have to call this guy. So I called him, like left him like a 9 message, because he was out a week. So I left him a lot of message. But I don't know. I said, you know what? I have to bump with a lot of phone calls and messages, so they know I can make noises. I can make the noise. So that's the only way. Past already 2 weeks, you know, the waiting. I asked God to put me on the phone somebody who really wanna help me. Somebody who is good and compassion in the heart. So some to touch that person on the phone. Jeff and me, we were like, what's happening? Why are they taking too long to give me the 60 days? You know, we were like that. I explained to Mrs. Dolphin the case, everything. And she says, okay, Mrs. Haynes, let me make a phone call right now. Stay on the line. Mrs. Haynes, you have to wait at least 15 days because it's before Jeff is more people that they are waiting for this process. I told Jeff, please stay with your spirit up and positive, because this is gonna happen. They're gonna reduce no matter what. I know that. We have to have the faith that everything is gonna happen soon. I check on the computer every single month, you know, for the release date of Jeff, because change, you know, every month, because he was in the programs. So after that phone call, the next day, I check, I check the computer, and I was in shock. They reduced the 60 days. They reduced it, and I was in shock. Because the prayers are powerful, very powerful. So God touched that woman, the angels, and that woman talked to somebody else, and because she listens to me, and she, something about the conversation with Mrs. Dolphin, that she make that phone call to another person, so they changed that. They changed it, because next day, she told me 15 days to wait, so next day, they reduced the 60 days, so I don't know what else to tell you. But I'm very blessed, and I'm very grateful to God, because God listens to prayers. But this is what happening, my friends, and I'm so happy for this. I'm so happy. You have no idea. But now that you know that they reduced the 60 days, so now you know that the time comes very soon, my friends. And you are witness of this, all this process. My beautiful spirits, Jeff has to show you something. Okay?
Yeah, I present to you my ask for the phone.
I'm very happy. Hey, Miguel! Hey, soon in home, soon in home, soon, soon, and you in home, 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 home. Hey, 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 hey! Farsa, farsa, farsa!
Officially deaf in one ear.
¿Qué? hijito de mi corazón.
Very grateful and appreciative of all the comments, beautiful words, the support that you guys have for me. I definitely can't wait to get out there and share my life with y'all. Get to know you guys individually. You have to email me on JPay. I've been waiting for some emails, so.
Jeff, I wrote a comment that said that they want to marry you. They want to marry you, that you are handsome.
Oh, yeah, I want to know who wants to marry me. They say me, so
what? Ay, hijo mío. I'm very happy, Jeff.
My heart is very appreciative of you guys. It's a love for you guys, so thank you guys once again. Love you guys.
My beautiful spirits, visit my store, One Beautiful Spirit, and you will see a beautiful jewelry and a beautiful stone quartz. And let me show you this one. This is a black tourmalite, and this help you to release the stress, the tension. Help you for this. Also, it's good for the anxiety, the anger. So, you know, increase the levels of your energy. So this is a beautiful, beautiful tourmalite stone. And also, I got this beautiful jewelry, this chunky necklace, and this one, look at this. Also, I have this bracelet. Look at this beautiful bracelet. Chunky bracelet. Give you a nice look. It is a nice look for your hand. And also rings. So go to the store, my friends. Go to the store and get a beautiful pieces of the jewelry that I have. I am here now in the parking lot of the post office. I'm gonna drop some package from the store, One Beautiful Spirit. Thank you so very much. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you so much for all your support. At the same time, today I start the process. It's the day that I'm going to mail the box to the facility where is Jeff, because Jeff is about to come home, so I'm sending him the clothing that they require. He has to be ready for when I go and pick him up. I am so nervous, excited, and I'm so happy, very happy with all this with all these moments coming very soon, my friends. I'm telling you, it's very soon. So, my friends, so lately, most of the nights that I am in bed, about to sleep, I cannot even close my eyes because I'm dreaming. I'm awake and I'm dreaming about, and I know it's happening soon, but about the moment that I'm gonna see my son Jeff and I'm gonna be out, that moment that I'm gonna hug my son Jeff, and the moment that I'm gonna be with him, that moment that I can hold his hands and touch him, and you know. So my friends, okay, let me show you. Oh, my friends, I cannot even talk because I'm a little nervous, because I'm nervous about that moment. This is the box that I have everything. I put a nice paper too, you know, I send him here the thing that they require, you know. So, and also the shoes are here. I don't want to open because I don't want to mess up pens. So this is the package today. I'm going to mail it. My beautiful spirits, thank you so much for coming back to my channel. Thank you so much for all your support. And thank you for being with me on this journey as a mother having a son incarcerated. Now I can count with my fingers the day that's coming very soon, very soon. And I'm gonna record my process when I'm gonna start preparing to fly, to go and see Jeff and pick up Jeff. And I'm gonna record everything, my friends. So it's gonna be very interesting, very, very interesting to watch me, what I'm gonna do everything that I'm going to do just to get there and pick up my son the day that they release my son from prison. Stay tuned, please. Good things coming. Good things coming. And it's about time. It's about time. God bless me and God protect me. And God give me the strength that I need. And I wish the same for all of you, my friends. A lot of strength in God y mucha fuerza. Siempre con positiva actitud. Always with positive attitude. Take care of yourself. I love you very much. And I will see you in my next video. Bye-bye.